for Alberta generally, I think it's important to show people that we're thinking about energy efficiency and renewable energy and thinking about our future as well.
The changing climate that results from an increase in greenhouse gas emissions is coming from emissions all around the world, including those emissions here in Alberta. And we're starting to see already a range of impacts. And so things like the flood that we had in Calgary some years ago now, forest fires that we've had both in Alberta up in the north, as well as the smoke that we sometimes get in our summers now in Alberta, those are all related to the changing climate. So what that means is climate change is going to impact every facet of our life, you know, our homes, the way that as individuals we get around, our broader communities, as well as how we grow our food and produce our food. All of these are impacted by both the extreme weather, the changing climate. We want to avoid getting to a point where that gets much worse.
We need to continue climate mitigation, but we need to put an equal push into adaptation work as well. And I think that's where our work is cut out for us, because we're so used to the language around reducing our emissions and being more energy efficient now, and that it's a bit hard to shift gears, but we have to do both. Complacency will put us in a lot more trouble. People are aware, and we've got things into place about changing the way we move, changing the way we power our homes and heat our homes in the winter.
Alberta is actually one of the best places in Canada to build out renewable electricity, especially wind and solar, but also geothermal as well. Bringing that understanding to Alberta, to be able to say, what can we do as Albertans to lead in that transformation, both in our own energy systems and how do we prepare for those changes to come to ensure that we have an economy that remains prosperous and strong.